When the Manila Trench finally ruptures, it might just awaken the widely considered extinct supervolcano in the Philippines, the Apolaki Caldera. Scientists have already warned that a megathrust earthquake from the Manila Trench could occur sooner than expected. It's so dangerous that it may possess the power to trigger one of the deadliest earthquakes of our generation. Such a disaster could paralyze the nation, wrecking critical infrastructure and leaving millions without homes. More than that, it has the potential to generate massive tsunamis ranging from 3 to 15 meters. The potential loss of life would be in the hundreds of thousands. But there's a lesser-known danger that could result after this disaster. One that hasn't been talked much about. It could reawaken the biggest caldera on Earth. So, you might ask, could an extinct volcano be awakened just like they've been sleeping all along? Well, history has provided us with some examples. The possibility of an extinct volcano coming to life is rare but definitely possible. Just take the case of Four-Peaked Mountain in Alaska, USA. This was believed to have been inactive for over 10,000 years before it suddenly started releasing steam and ash. Another notable example is Chile's Chaitén volcano. This had been quiet for more than 9,000 years and was thought to be extinct. In 2008, it erupted unexpectedly, spewing ash 30 kilometers into the sky and forcing the evacuation of nearby communities. So yes, nature has shown us not to be too confident, even when a volcano has been quiet for millions of years, as in the case of the Apolaki Caldera. But before we explore this intriguing possibility, let's first get to know these forces of nature better. First stop, the Manila Trench. It's a prominent 1,500 kilometers oceanic feature located in the Western Pacific at the tip of southern Taiwan, stretching up to Mindoro. This subduction zone dives nearly 5,400 meters down. It's so deep that we could stack 7 Burj Khalifas into it and still have room to spare. This zone acts as the underlying force behind much of the seismic activity in the region. This was also responsible for the formation of the volcanic chain along Luzon's western flank, which includes the infamous Mount Pinatubo. This fault line has been quiet for centuries, but that silence is not necessarily something that we should ignore. In fact, this is what keeps scientists on edge. This is why this fault line is considered one of the most dangerous in the world. Since Spanish records began in the 1560s, not a single earthquake stronger than magnitude 7.6 has struck along this fault. The tectonic energy buildup here is so enormous that experts are warning that it has the potential to generate a magnitude 8.8 and 9.3 megathrust earthquake. Next stop, the Apolaki Caldera. Deep beneath the Philippine Rise, east of Luzon, lies a colossal caldera so vast it has been recognized as the largest in the world. It measures roughly 150,000 meters across, twice the size of the famous Yellowstone caldera. Its deepest points plunge between 3,000 and 4,000 meters below the ocean's surface. When it formed, it produced some of the most powerful underwater volcanic eruptions ever recorded on Earth. These eruptions were so intense and frequent that they split the sea floor, creating massive ring-shaped fractures called ring faults. Officially classified as extinct, it has long been considered not a threat. However, new geological findings and changing tectonic conditions have led some scientists to take a second look at this assumption. Now let's take a closer look at the scenario we posed in the intro of our video, that a Manila Trench quake could generate the tectonic strain needed to jolt an ancient magma system back to life. To get a better grasp on this intriguing possibility, we need to understand first how an earthquake works. Earthquakes aren't isolated events. Its sudden release of energy sends powerful shockwaves through the Earth. When a fault ruptures, it sets off several kinds of seismic waves. These waves spread through the Earth in the same way ripples travel across water or sound moves through the air. They can cross thousands of kilometers, bending and bouncing as they pass through the crust and mantle. So, a magnitude 9 earthquake along the Manila Trench could send powerful energy surging across the Philippines and all the way to the Philippine Rise. Once this happens, it could subtly alter pressures in the crust beneath the Philippine Rise. Even without a new supply of magma, the violent shaking could still break apart the surrounding rock. Over time, the heat from this movement could warm ancient materials underground, slowly leading to a buildup of pressure. Over the course of years, or even decades, that kind of stress could be enough to stir the Apolaki Caldera back to life. These aren't just insane assumptions. Similar patterns have also been observed in other parts of the world. Recent events have proven that powerful earthquakes can influence volcanic activity. When a magnitude 8.8 earthquake struck off the coast of Russia, scientists observed what seemed to be a chain reaction of unrest across the Pacific Ring of Fire. The first to respond was Kluchevskoye in eastern Russia, erupting after more than 600 years of inactivity. Soon after, five more volcanoes in Russia erupted, all located along the Pacific Ring of Fire. A vast arc of seismic and volcanic activity encircling the Pacific Ocean, this region remains one of the most volatile and unpredictable geological zones on the planet. That doesn't mean a rupture along the Manila Trench would automatically unleash an eruption from Apolaki. The reality is, science doesn't have the technology to predict such a chain reaction with precision. The link between earthquakes and eruptions remains one of the great unknowns of geology. However, science demonstrates that the Earth functions as an interconnected system, where a significant release of energy in one location can impact regions far away. Apolaki may lie quiet today beneath layers of seawater, but it sits in the Ring of Fire. The possibility that one of its ancient features could become active again is not within the realm of impossibility. If our fear were indeed to become a reality, scientists believe it could, in theory, unleash a VEI-8 eruption. That's the most extreme on the index. It would hurl several thousand cubic kilometers of pyroclastic material into the sky, an event that could eclipse even history's most legendary eruptions. The effects would be truly devastating. Apart from releasing rivers of lava, it could destroy everything nearby. With millions of people living close to the supervolcano, the number of lives lost would be unimaginable. Entire towns and cities could disappear under thick layers of ash. Rescue operations would be almost impossible. Roads would be buried, bridges would collapse, airplanes wouldn't be able to fly, and communication lines would go down, cutting people off from help. But the worst part might come after the eruption ends. Huge amounts of ash and gas would spread into the upper atmosphere, blocking sunlight. Scientists call this a volcanic winter. This would plunge not just the Philippines, but the world into darkness, famine, and chaos. But we could take comfort in the knowledge that the caldera is located beneath the ocean. The depth would act like a shield. The ash would not rise into the sky, and the toxic gases would stay trapped below. You know who would take the biggest hit? The sea life around it. Scorching water mixed with ash and toxic gases like sulfur dioxide and hydrochloric acid could quickly poison the ocean, wiping out everything from tiny plankton to fish and corals. If that happens, the people living near the area would feel the effects as well. Since there would be fewer fish in the sea, families might struggle to find enough food to eat. Fishermen would also have a hard time catching enough fish to sell, which means they could earn much less money. In the end, nature holds a power far beyond what our greatest technology can achieve. It can generate a force that could awaken even a volcano once believed to be extinct. However, if the Manila Trench rupture could do it to the Apolaki Caldera, only time can tell. But what are your thoughts about this? We think you'll love this next video. As always, until the next one.